What I'm going to say tonight, today, not tonight, this morning, I am talking to you, but I'm talking to me too. So whatever I say, I need to receive it too, yes? We know that the Bible is a book, that we can read it and can stay here. But we need this to come here. And I need that. And I know you need that. I'm not saying because you're a pastor, when you go to holidays, you walk on water. No, no. We need all the things that we know to come here and to be applied in our lives. Yes? Let's start with something funny. ¿Podemos poner el video? El video. Hay un video. Yes? If you remember last time I spoke, I said that I was preparing a preaching, and I saw this musical sister act and the song that said, I will follow him, I will follow him where he may go. Yes? I started to cry and said, whoa, God, what you're doing with me? Yeah? I'm a tough man, I'm a mechanic, I do things strong and metal and things hard, I'm building bricks. And I hear this song and I start to break in. And this happened again. And this is, for us, if we can place it, I started to break again. And it's funny. Yeah? ¿Tiene audio? Yes. Yeah. I really had a nice time. And I had to prepare this clip. Amen. I think this is the summary of what I'm going to talk today. Yes? All I want for Christmas is him, is you. I want you for me. I want you. Yeah? And sometimes we get to Christmas and it gets October, November, September, and things started to appear in the shops for Christmas, and we started to get this atmosphere of Christmas, yeah, and we start to buy, I don't know, glitters and presents, panettone, for those that are coming from Latin America, it's panettone, yeah, European things, so good, and things that we like, and we start to breathe that air in Christmas, yes, and the title of my preaching today is called Our Christmas of Every Day, yes? Or Our 365-Day Christmas, yeah? Whatever you want to say, I think that it will make sense of what we are talking today. And we have, what we have for Christmas? Una foto. Yes? Christmas tree? Yes, so this way. Oh, there is another Christmas tree is a bit more simple. Yeah? You can have a very big Christmas tree with lots of things, with not so many things. Someone will recognize this one? This is our house, yeah. That's our Christmas tree. Yes, yes, it's a surprise, eh? And we have what? Bells. We need to have bells in our Christmas tree, and the songs that are in the radio or everywhere. You go to the shopping and it's all these tling, 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 tling. ring, bells everywhere. Yeah, it's so good. The city is full of lights. We needed lights. We needed to put all shiny lights everywhere. And this. And what about this? Presents? Yeah? Is it Mr. Bean that sends his own present because no one sends presents to him? So, or cards? Yeah, cards. And he received cards and, oh, it's a Christmas card. And he sent it to himself. So we need to have all this in Christmas. We need the deer. I don't know if the deer, but another one. Oh, this is good in Christmas. Now, what about this, the turkey? Yeah? I remember when I was young, I had a six-pack here. Now I think I have six turkeys here. It's terrible. Yes, it's so good. The deer? This is not Rudolph. He hasn't got the nose. Yeah? What else? Oh, we need to have the Christmas scenery, you say? Yeah, the Christmas scenery with the donkeys and what else we have? I don't know. Oh, you like sweet things? Christmas pudding. Yes? No, you don't like Christmas pudding? Christmas cake. Yeah? Reindeer. Look at that. That's also you need to have in the scenery there. So we're going to build our... they are so good, eh? Chickens, yeah? When we do the scenery, we place all these little things that makes the scenery nice and beautiful. And some people go over and they put loads of things. Some cultures, they put even politicians there and faces of politicians in the scenery. What else we have? Horses, hay, and that. We know what is that. That's the manger. That's the center where we do things, where we prepare everything surrounding the manger. Oh, no. Yeah, we need snow. Sometimes here in Oxford, we don't have Christmas with snow. Do we have? Will we have this year? No, he doesn't know. Oh, good. Yeah, we need that. Do we? Yeah. Another one? Oh, that's a good one. The three kings. Three kings. It's important thing. Yeah. It's not the same time, but it's important. That is kind of Rudolph, but with a black nose. It needs to be red so it shines so Father Christmas can go and have light. Yes? Yes? Santa. We need Santa Claus. Yeah, we need all these things outside. I see houses with this big Santa. Yeah, this all air, red, beautiful things. Well, we need more. And also that's another manger. What we have more? Another one, if there is another one? No? Yeah? She recognized this one, you recognize this? We need Joseph and Mary.
Yeah. Where is Jesus?
That's the point. Now you spoil it. You spoil it.
Sorry.
Okay, that's Joseph and Mary. Cool. I wanted to make tension. Now it's all spoiled. Okay, no worry. You want to get married? Okay, next one. Is there another one? There is no more. Okay, good. These are stories. These are fabulas. ¿Cómo se dice? Stories. Fairy tales. Yes, it's better. Yeah. Some are kind of stories like Santa Claus. There was someone who was bringing presents to the prisoners, and that becomes a little bit more popular. And depends what the country you are. You have Father Christmas, and you and it's not so important the others. Some countries, they have the three kings that are so important that the Father Christmas is not so important. Yes, you know, Catalonia. And these things are filling our Christmas, yes? And we're going to read, if it's possible, Matthew 1, 18 to 25. Yes, this is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quickly. Quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord has said through the prophet: "The virgin will be with a child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us." When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus. Wow, good. This is a story. This is real. Someone has wrote what really has happened. This is not about reindeers, or glitter, or tinsel. How do you say in the Christmas tree? The string. Tinsel. Something like that. This is not about, this is something serious. This is something that happened. This is something so amazing that we still unconsciously live in it, even if we send man to the moon or now to Mars, we are still using the day that Jesus Christ was born. So unconsciously we know that today is the 18th of December because it was after Jesus was born that day, And all the world and religions, they will make before Christ and after Christ, or Anna Domina. Before Christ is BC, and AD is not after death. It's just Anna Domina. Otherwise, we will have 30 years of difference in between. Sorry about that. Yes, so this is a real story. Yeah, we're going to read now Matthew 2, 13, and a few more, 14 and 15. When they have gone, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. He's talking about the magi. They came, and when they came to offer their worship and their gifts, it's a lovely story about the Magi, that seems to be they were Persians, kind of. Maybe they came from the East, they study. They were people that they knew what were doing. They were doing. They possibly they studied the story of Esther, how the God of the Jews gave salvation to them. And all the others in the Bible, that even from the Persian Empire, they've been rescued by God. So these people, they had a knowledge, and they looked, and through that knowledge, they found that there is a star that was going to guide them to Jesus Christ. It's interesting, and I wish you can go and do some research about this, because really it makes your shivers, because it's so good what it happened with these kings. But we're not going to talk about the kings. We're going to talk about Joseph and Mary and the shepherds, yes? So when they have gone, the Magi's, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. "Get up," he said, "take the child and his mother and escape to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you, for Herod is going to search for the child to kill him." So he got up, took the child and his mother during the night, and left to Egypt, where he stayed until the death of Herod. And so was fulfilled what the Lord had said through the prophet, "Out of Egypt I called my son." This is good. Yeah. He obeyed to go out. He obeyed to come back, but he went back to another place, so we went to Nazareth. It's so good to follow this. I cannot explain all this because, not because I don't have the time, because I'm sorry for you, you have to be seated there listening to me. Just by respect, you don't have to get up and go. So, but it's a lovely story, and it will take a lot of time and a lot of interest to hear. So we're going to read a little bit more. It's Luke 2:8. That's when the angel appeared to the shepherds, yeah? "And they were shepherds living in the fields nearby, keeping watch of their flocks at night." This is a nice message. "And the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified." I would be terrified as well, I tell you, yeah. "But the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger.' Suddenly a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests.' When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, 'Let's go to Bethlehem and see these things that have happened, which the Lord has told us about.' So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was laying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they have heard, had seen, which were just as they had been told." Amen. Cool. It's like the scenery. We see the shepherds, yeah, the sheep. It's so good. It's so good. So we see an angel that appears to people that were in the fields. Sometimes you think, this is a small message. I think it has a lot of little bits and pieces here. Sometimes you think, I am in my things. Sometimes I'm not that good. Sometimes I don't care. I am I don't know, I people reject me. These people were outside somewhere, and the Lord managed to give the news, the information where they were. A place where nobody cares of, in the middle of the fields. They were in the fields. The Lord reached them, even if they were somewhere where nobody knows about you. Yes, he will get the message to you. The three kings, they received the message through knowledge. The shepherds didn't have that chance. But the Lord gave the chance to tell, there is a Savior for you. There is a Savior for you. We don't have to be worried how the Lord reach us. The Lord will reach for us. Amen? Amen. This is a true story. So, the things of Christmas are a bit of fantasy, and it's a bit like our lives. We fill with decorations and lights that you can call career or hope for tomorrow, or I don't know, maybe a brand new car that will take me somewhere. Yeah, another decoration, maybe a better reindeer that runs faster, or maybe a house, maybe a girl or a boy, depends if you are young. Don't laugh. Yes, there are lots of things that make decorations in our lives. But the important thing is what you have in your manger. What is in your manger? We have seen the manger empty. Jesus wasn't there, it was Joseph and Mary. And sometimes, every day, many times, in our lives, we have the manger empty. And we need Jesus to be there. We need Jesus to change our lives. We need Jesus to guide us. We need him in the center of our scenery. Amen? Amen. You know, just 1 second, it's going to be a little bit longer. You know, there are presents. Yeah, the shepherds, we don't know what, it doesn't say in the Bible what they brought a present. Maybe they brought bread or cheese, or I don't know. But they were in a hurry. When the angel said, all these things, and the host came and sing, and they shine, they were frightened. After all that, they hurry to go to see what is this baby there? What is happening? What is this Savior? This is a little message for us. Yes? Maybe you have to leave your flock. Maybe you have to leave your idea. Maybe you have to leave things apart. The things that are immediate, that are inmediatas. The currently things that you are doing, maybe they have to be set it apart to hurry to see what the Lord is saying. Look, put Jesus in your manger. Have a look if Jesus is in your manger. Go and search. There is a Savior for you. Just leave the things that you are doing. Maybe it's 5 minutes. Maybe it's 1 year. Maybe it's all your idea of what life is. But put Jesus in the center. Jesus is a gift. It's a present for God, for all of us. And this is funny, because presents are good. Jesse came from Spain, and she gave me a little bottle of olive oil from the Mediterranean, the area where my mom was born. And I love it. And you know what? The present said something about Jesse, something about the present itself, and something about me. Jesse cared about me, and she thought about me, so I know she did. The present was good. It's a good quality thing. The present talks about himself. Sorry, Jesse and Stephen. Yes? And also, it says something about me. They know that I like these Mediterranean things. On the other hand, I have my family that they know what I need, and they bought me a shirt, not this one. Yeah? And sometimes the presents are a bit uncomfortable. So I put that shirt, which is large, and I am XL. Yeah? So I like the shirt. It's a good quality. The present talks about itself. It's a good quality. And it talks about those that have given it to me. Yes? Because they love me. They know what I need. They want to see me nice, large, and slim, and yes, but I'm not like that. Yeah, my six pack is gone. I never had a six pack. Oh, well, yeah. So sometimes presents are uncomfortable. The story of Jesus Christ, this is serious. He has came to be human, to tell you that you cannot. Jesus is saying, I have to come to the world to become human, to tell you that you cannot be saved unless it's through me. Even though you can read books about you can do this, you cannot. Unless Jesus is in the manger, unless Jesus is in the center of the scenery of this nativity, this Christmas, you cannot be saved. This is the great thing. Uncomfortable, some people. When the three kings came, the king Herod wanted to know where he was to kill him. The kings, the Magi, they went through another way, and Herod sent to kill all the children that were under 2 years old. The gift of God for some people is uncomfortable. Just imagine the mother and father of those that had a baby just now, and they were killed because Jesus Christ was born. So it could be uncomfortable for you. Maybe you are in the place of the shepherds, that everything is great. I'm doing my business, I'm doing my career. The only thing I have to do is just to leave it apart and take care of this baby. Maybe you are like Joseph and Mary. Joseph, he was not his idea to flee away from where he was. He wanted to have a family. He wanted to be a father. But a father of God, that's a difficult one. Yeah? Mary wanted to have a family. Yes? Why not? I guess she wanted to have a family. But it wasn't in her plans to be pregnant before she got married. Sometimes the present, the gift, is uncomfortable. I don't know what this is saying to you. I know he had talked to me a lot. And really all I want to do, to have for Christmas, is him, is you. All I want for Christmas is you. So when I heard the song, I don't want anything else. I don't want the presents under the Christmas tree. They're welcome, by the way. Yeah. But what I really want is him in the center of my manger, in the center of my heart. It doesn't matter how your stable is. It doesn't matter how many animals you have and how smelly it is. It doesn't matter that even a manger in the heart can cuddle a future king. Amen? And this is all the message of today. All we want for Christmas is him. All we need for everyday Christmas is him. All we need is to have him in our little manger of our hearts. Amen. I hope the Lord is talking to you as he was talking to me. I'm really been emotional with this. I had tears in my heart, in my eyes, in my heart and in my eyes. And every time I think about this, I say, why I had my manger empty so long without you in the middle. All I want for Christmas really is you, Lord. Amen. God bless you all.